guys, it's Cinnamon Cooney, your Art Sherpa. How you doing? Hope you're okay. We've had a little bit of a journey to get on live today. My husband John's on the mic staring warily at the tech, which is never assuring.
No, I think it's okay. I just
he's
had to.
He's giving it the eye.
The eye.
So if the principles of Fonzie apply here, then it should behave.
Sometimes you master the Kraken, sometimes the Kraken masters you.
You missed my bad Fonzie pun.
I
did an A, and it was terrible.
A. As long as there's no shark jumping.
So, 10 of you gets that. But actually, probably more, because, you know, that was one of the longest running shows ever on TV. So, you're going to see here, John's going to put up we're going to be doing the Cheshire Cat today, and we're going to be doing it in two stages. We're going to be doing it just as a painting, and then also as a blacklight painting.
There you go.
So to get this in blacklight, I got to put that in first. Now, if you have no intention of taking this to blacklight, you can change the colors out, the purple and the blue for any other set of colors and the yellow out for any other set of colors. Mm-hmm. Right? So if you want it to be blue and orange or whatever you want to do in your Cheshire Cat is fine. If you're going to be doing this, and this is how the blacklight painting is going to look in regular light. This is my whole thing. Is that I don't like them just to look good in black light. I like them to look good in regular light. And I've done a few of these, as many of you know by now. So I've kind of got the little process down. So I can get you through that. So this is the goal of the day. We're going to be meeting back later today at night of you to do the black light version. But now we're doing this version, which you can do, again, yellow and orange. Let's talk about this fabulous. Let's look at this. Ooh, this delicious canvas here.
I gotta get over there and
see you're all like.
There we go.
Ooh, isn't that lovely? So this is a canvas board that I have just simply brushed on black gesso with. And I've started to sketch in the design. I really want you to know that there's no need for you to feel like you have to be able to draw. I have a traceable, it's in the description. It's on the website,
Come back over here to the main screen.
TheArtSherpa.com.
Yeah, I can pull that up for you.
No, that's not it. TheArtSherpa.com. So you can either go to Pinterest, you can go to the link below, or you can go to TheArtSherpa.com to find the traceable. I've been working in the studio, painting, doing designs. There's some new directions I'm trying to take us. We're trying to work out rebooting the quest for 2017. So there's just been a bunch of work. Let's take a deep breath. Clearly, I need one.
There we go.
We'll let school and kids go. And the TV and the news and everything go. And the minutia of life and everything that's been going on go. And we just survived trick-or-treating, which is...
We did. Okay.
Trick-or-treating is super fun and also super stressful.
I got all my cameras back now, so I feel better.
He has all his cameras back, and so things are going well.
Yeah.
I've got a white chalk pencil by Generals. This is a Generals white chalk.
Mm-hmm.
And I can sketch this in. Today, when we do wishes, I might do them on the back of the canvas, just because we're going to have such a translucent, brushy technique today that it might show through. So let's first get your wishes. If you're brand new here and you've never been here, you're like, why are you still talking? Because that's how we do.
That's how we do.
That's how I actually teach you to paint. I can be all quiet and paint myself. It goes real fast. I hardly even need to speed paint because I'm that fast. But if you would like to paint, it helps if I talk to you.
Mm-hmm.
Just telling you honestly.
So what did you painted that canvas there? Oh, so yeah. We're going to put wishes on the back first.
Well, I can show them. Yeah. I just use Liquitex black gesso. You can buy a pre-black canvas. Yeah. I really like the Liquitex black gesso. And if you use the Liquitex black gesso, you don't have to then also use Mars black.
Mm-hmm.
Just a little money-saving tip there. I'm going to get my pencil. Do we have any wishes?
We do. We have a wish for positive energy to Spoodie's husband. He's for an interview.
Can you say that Spoonie?
Spoodie. S-P-O-O-T-Y. Spoodie.
Spoodie's husband for an interview. Let's get that, man. Have that go well.
And there's I'm gonna scroll back up here. There's a bunch of wishes up here for There's a couple of wishes here. Let's go for good interviews and good jobs. I see a couple of them up here for everyone to have good job interviews. And that's, you know, I know that there's a couple of those that are close to home for us as well, where everyone got some people looking for new jobs.
Let's wish our community gets the new jobs they're going for and they're going into the holiday season employed.
And safe travels, too.
Yeah.
There's a big travel season coming up here. A lot of people are traveling. I see some stuff going overseas. And a couple of people are not feeling well. I see Angela is a little under the weather. I know that you were feeling a little under the weather. So probably a couple of good wishes
out
there.
Is that Angela Anderson?
I'm not sure if it was Angela Anderson. No, we got a couple of Angelas in here in our community.
Angelas feel well.
All Angelas feel well. I don't think it was Angela
all
Anderson.
All of them. The rest, you Tinas, no. All Angelas.
And for Dom at the dentist.
Okay, Dominique. I just really want you to be okay. I'm wishing for some viral videos before the end of the year.
Yay, viral videos!
We need some of those, even though we're a big, goofy channel.
Oh, it's Angela Schlau.
Angela Schlau.
S-C-H-O-L-O-U-G-H.
Wishing for that. And I would like us just some just all of planet Earth some peace.
Mm-hmm.
I know we're going through a lot, but just some peace on planet Earth. And safety for those. There's so much weather, and I just really wish everyone is safe during this crazy weather.
Yeah.
All right. Let's flip this around. This canvas board. Canvas board can save you some money in your painting journey. It's perfectly acceptable. It can be framed. Everything can be done with it.
Mm-hmm.
And it stores a little easier than canvases. This is an 11 by 14.
Mm-hmm.
That's nice. It has a nice sturdy texture. I've got my white chalk pencil. And I'm going to sketch in my little eyes here. How I'm going to do that is, one of the things that you might do, trick, is you might give yourself a line to anchor your eyes. I often like to give myself a line. The eyes go up pretty far. They're pretty high up on, especially this last rendition of the Cheshire Cat for Alice in Wonderland,
mm-hmm.
which I just had to watch through the looking glass.
Oh, yeah.
Ugh, not happy with that one. All right. I'm going to put his little pupils, which are these narrow slivers, like almond slivers right here.
Mm-hmm.
Just give him some nice big almond slivers. Cat's noses are sort of funny. His is almost, he's like a Persian. It's almost direct between his little eyes.
Yep.
So I make this little M shape. I'm going to come down with two little angles, scoop in, and come down to this diamond. You can also give your face a horizontal anchor just to help you keep those features organized.
Mm-hmm.
When you're learning to draw, that's a good thing that you can do. I'm going to create a nice big smile, curving down and then curving this up. And I am going to draw on the teeth, which are these sort of wide, interesting little points down. When I was looking at this guy, his teeth in design were kind of crazy.
Yeah.
Very interesting.
Very interesting teeth. I like how they came in blacklight, too.
When they come in blacklight, it's on a whole nother level. Him in blacklight
is awesome.
I can barely photograph it. I was actually sharing it with my mom and some people and have to send two different photographs because the camera can't see all the color.
Yeah. It's
as it is. So I have to bracket it in two places, even on my phone,
mm-hmm.
just to get an accurate representation. These two should be taller in here, I feel. Just got to get these teeth in. Now, his ears are almost lined up to his pupils. And what I like to do is I swoop it out and then just make a little kind of... What is that shape? Do you feel like this is a little leafy?
Is that kind of like a leaf?
It's a little bit like a little leafy shape.
It's an ear shape.
His ears are not up and perched. They're weirdly to the side and goofy. And it's an important feature of him, I feel. When you're doing him. And then you can do him either with a highly round head. And don't sketch in his whole head. Just kind of give yourself a general guideline for shape. I made him more like almost a squished circle. He's an oval for me.
Mm-hmm.
Is what he is. So that's how I got him in. Breathing. I'm going to enjoy a little sippy and hydrate here.
Little. Now that's for your.
I'm sporting some Paula original couture.
I was just going to say that.
And home gear.
You got her glass there. You got the hat and the apron. And I like the back of the hat. The back of the hat's really cute.
You see it?
You see all the eek? That is so cute. Thank you. Yeah, that was a great, that was a wonderful gift.
So I'm going to get a nice number 10 bright.
Okay.
Right? This beautiful brush has a firm filament. Can you see that there? When you're feeling it, when you're touching it, it shouldn't be soft. Multimedia brushes and watercolor brushes tend to be soft. Brushes for heavy-bodied acrylic aren't like bristles. They're not super scratchy, but they're firm. A little too firm for makeup. I like a nice weight to my handle, and this is number 10. You could do things with a number 8. You could do things with a number 6. I just really like for this size canvas, I like a number 10.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, I'm so lost today.
What are you?
Size down. I'm going to get a thumbs down. Don't do it.
What you gonna, why would you do that?
I'm just thinking I want to size down to an 8.
You want to size down to an 8?
Well, here's the difference. If you're wondering why did I make that decision? Look at the difference in the size of the brushes. Bristles are a little shorter on the 8. They're a little narrower. Give me a little more control. I can make tighter turns and work tighter spaces.
Now, you were just giving yourself grief for what you tell other artists to do. And that's to not be afraid to switch brushes.
Just, yeah, don't ever be afraid to switch brushes. I'm just afraid because I have YouTube to worry about. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to wet my brush and drag off the extra water. Right? When you feel it, if you were to, say, brush it on your skin here, you would want it to be damp but not wet, would be the amount that you would want. And I'm going to put in my yellow highlights. I'm going to take a little of my titanium white. You can see me coming over here and pulling a little bit onto this brush. And then over here, a little bit on there. I'm not even really worried about mixing it. And I'm going to come right here to under the nose. And I'm going to make that inside the nose whisker highlight right over the black. Brushing on the edge of my brush. What are we doing? Oh, thank you. I'm going to get a little more yellow here and just come back over here. Now, I would know I had too much water if this wasn't really covering. And I'm going to just pull along the lip a little bit, and then I'm going to come do the other side. Just the same thing. Just making this little bit of yellow here. This is going to be real important later when we take him into blacklight. If you're not going to do the black light, you can make this orange if you want different than blue, yellow, and purple. That's okay.
Whew. You can flip that over.
I know.
You're just enjoying the...
I'm just trying to... You know what happens is, like, sometimes you got to find your own relax.
Yeah.
Sometimes you got to find your own zen. All right. I'm going to come under the eye. Sometimes I need the painting as much as you guys need the painting.
Mm-hmm. It's a good painting day.
It's a good painting day. I'm going to pull just a little bit down. It's going to be wider at the outer edge and then narrow as we get closer to the pupil. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side.
Trish thinks it's an awesome day.
Awesome day for a paint. We need it.
Sometimes
we need it. I know I need it right now. I just grabbed some more yellow and I'm just pulling it down.
And we're going to get our glow on tonight, aren't we?
We're going to super get on our glow, and a lot of this was about planning for the glow, because you have to plan a glow painting.
You do.
Yeah, you have to have an idea of what you're doing before you glow. Otherwise, it just disappears into the black canvas, which can be cool, but if you want it to exist during the daytime and nighttime, you need to have a little bit of a plan.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to come up here on top of the eye. Things I learned doing jellyfish.
You didn't...
Oh, I need to underpaint these jellyfish.
Mm-hmm.
Or they don't look good during the daytime.
You did a lot of jellyfish, though, didn't you?
Well, in blacklight, I've got to do some regular jellyfish here soon for people who just aren't into blacklight painting, I think.
Yep.
So I'm making a little above the eyes. See that with the yellow?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. He's a very stately fellow. He does not apologize for being himself.
No.
We have had so many requests to do the Cheshire Cat. And we're definitely hitting the requests lately
mm-hmm.
to do characters. which is sort of fun. So he's got a nice little bit here coming up. And, you know, I'm going to add some stripes on his forehead and above his head, pulling out this white. The white, sometimes what happens with your yellow is your yellow can be very transparent. And a small amount of white pigment, especially really good white pigment, like this is really good. This is my favorite white on the market, which is golden titanium white. So not sponsored. It's just an opinion that I've had that John can tell you I've had for years.
Years.
I feel golden titanium white is my favorite titanium white. I have a perception that it always is the most buttery, most pigmented, and can correct even an inexpensive paint's faults. So that's why I'm always like doing that. And yellow, even a good yellow, can be very transparent.
You make it sound like it's a super paint.
I might feel that way. I don't have a scientific reason for feeling that way. I have an artistic reason for feeling that way. But it is a feeling that I've held probably for about 2 decades.
Yeah.
So, you know, opinions, you have them. I'm going to put in some little stripes here up the center, like above the little nose here, because he's a tabby. Is he a fabulously colorful tabby? Yes, he is. And you can see how I'm getting this as I'm sort of working the corner of the brush, and I'm just pulling this up here. See, a little tabby there. And then I feel he needs another little tabby on the center line. Does it mean I won't have purple and blue coming up here real soon? Right? And then maybe a little tabbiness out here. Be fabulous, Mr. Cheshire Cat. But if you're painting really, really student paints, you can find a good white will help your yellows work a lot better. You know, as you're working out your coverage, I'm going to take another little, we're going to go here. And then maybe another little one here. I like these. I'm having some fun. Now we need two more little yellow lines up here. It's just wonderful to make this little fur because he sort of just pieces together like a puzzle. It's one of the things I like about doing tabbies or patterned animals is sometimes the pattern can help you. Lean into it. It's going to be widest. These brush strokes are going to be widest on the edge of the brush, just dashing along, and then they're going to taper down. A lot like eyebrows, but they're not eyebrows. And then I'm going to put a little yellow at the top of this ear. This is going to help me later when I blacklight this yellow, when I come in with that orange. They're going to work together. They're going to be friends. And I'm going to put a little fur out this ear. See right here? So I'm going to be a little furish.
Mm-hmm.
I'm on the corner edge of the brush. I'm just pulling it out, pulling it out, pulling it out. I'm going to come over here. I'm going to do the same thing. You know what I think it is, John? I think it's that I'm candy. Too much candy.
You have your sugar jitters.
Too much yesterday. The kids have decided that love is sharing.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't understand mom's healthy life choices. And then you end up in this weird place where you're like, well, if you love me, you'll eat my Tootsie Roll.
And it's not just the Tootsie, it's the last bite of the Tootsie Roll.
Yeah, it's the slobbery last bite of the Tootsie Roll. It's the one where you really gotta love them. It's a love test. So I'm just going around and making sure that I have the coverage that I want at this stage with my paint. You can see me kind of going around, just making sure that this covers how I want. Now the outside of his little fur here and up top has also got a little bit of this yellow. And I like to put this in. So I'm going to come here and I've got this dry brush. And you can see when it's dry and I work the corner, I can make kind of these cool little, look how fur-like that is. That's not a specialty brush. It's just this brush. Me going, dry brush, dash, 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 dash.
Oh. That seems
so magical. Just going to come along here on the outside edge that I drew. He's got his little ruff. Cat people are like, yes, it's a ruff.
It's a mane.
It's a mane. It's really what it is danger to John. Hidden in this fur. Is about a day of laying in bed not being able to breathe.
It's an allergy attack waiting to happen.
It's really funny when you take John to a cat house, too, because it's like all the cats in the house know
mm-hmm.
that he's allergic to them, and they decide they love him best. Everyone that's visiting who could totally hold them and cuddle them and pet them and breathe, no. They want that guy, the one that's crawling up the corner trying to get away. It's fabulous. Not for him later.
No.
So I'm going to just continue coming around and playing with the little rough. Did we get, we're asking for new candy approval? Oh. Who has too much candy in their house right now? Who?
Oh, I think that I know. Oh, what was it? Somebody was just saying that they had an entire box of candy.
I'm sorry.
And some candied, I think candied apples. I saw someone saying something about candied apples. I'm gonna go back up here and take a look at this.
Okay, now to make my life easy, I'm going to put out some of this titanium white and fluid. You can use your regular titanium white. I'm just super, super lazy. But I've let it plug up, which is the issue with that product.
Mm.
Anyhow, the reason that I sometimes like to do this instead of the heavy body is that way I don't have to thin it during a show, which can be kind of an issue for me, including like putting a short brush in the tall container.
What are you looking for?
My short brush that I brought over to do this task. My little number two shader.
Oh.
Because I got a number six shader.
Today's been a little missed button pressing all around. I missed button press. I've been pushing.
I love you guys. Does that help? I'm going to do something that's going to freak John out completely.
Oh no. She's going to disappear. Let me go get it. You talk to the people.
I'll talk to the people. So John's going to look for my shader over there, which I don't really personally think that he's going to be able to find. I'm going to hydrate up.
This one? Stunt hands. All right, so back to the painting.
This is a number two shader. You should be able to get these like online at Michael's. This is not the extra firm filament. This is just the regular multimedia firm filament. And because of the small size of the brush and the softness of the paint, this is a more ideal tool. You guys might not know that, so I tell you that.
It is. Oh, there
I'm
you go.
Going
oh,
to
this.
Come over here and just real quick put in my teeth.
Those look so cool.
Now, the nice thing about having your blackout is you don't really need a lot for this, but if you have any boo-boos or accidents or you have to clean anything up, the black will help you do that.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just putting these in. And you can see like the fluid paint really, really helps me. By the way, if you've got Hansa yellow, I might have said that at the beginning, you're good too. Hansa yellow is a good exchange for CAD yellow medium. On top of hue.
Mm-hmm.
But I know sometimes places don't have it. And I think Hansa is more widely available. Things I've learned since I've been on YouTube.
Hansa. That's just a cool name.
Yeah, if I could go back in time and tell my artist self starting out, I would be like, guess what you don't know?
Oh,
so many
oh,
things.
Where to begin?
So many things.
Go get
you
an
don't
MBA.
Know.
Go get an MBA.
Well, no, I still wouldn't do that. I like my advertising arts thing.
But in addition to.
You would do that.
Add to that, yes.
I don't know. It's working out pretty well for me. I'm painting every day.
Well, you are. It's true.
I pay my bills creatively.
We do.
We do.
We're creatively paying our bills.
As are most people around the world.
It only hurts when it laughs.
Just putting him in. I'm hoping you guys are liking these themes of these, you know, fan paints where they're based on popular characters.
Yeah, I think so. We got over 140 people who are hanging out with us right now. 117 likes. Thank you
did I lose a bunch of people at the beginning?
No. Thank you guys. It's been great. I appreciate you guys all coming and hanging out here. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. And when we get to 300 likes or comments or people in the room, we are Sherpa and we make the Sherpa dance. And I see all those little likes coming in there. We like the likes.
I like likes. I live on likes. Nom 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 nom.
She likes the likes.
Like little fishies, I eat them. So I get the little teeth in. The other thing when my brush is small that I'm going to pull in is around this little nose.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to, at first, just pull out a little phthalo blue. I'm going to grab a little of my heavy body white. Or I could do my fluid. It really wouldn't matter at this stage. This is my glazing medium I'm such a fan of. Keeps my paint from drying on me too quick. And I'm going to just paint this in this darker blue. Painting it in. Paint it in. Super fun. It actually is. You're like, it's not fun to paint a nose. Yes, it is. Super fun. Super duper fun.
Oh, and there's a lot of people saying congratulations on your, I guess you rolled 84,000 subs.
Did I?
I.
Woo! I'm really surprised to have any after this really... awkward. You know, you can't be like on all days. And I think that's important to realize.
Are you feeling off?
We're not all things all days.
Are you feeling off today?
You know, I am. But I think that that's just, you know.
I think there's a little bit of a cold going around. So it may just be a little.
And I think that there's also, you know, you come off the candy and the late night trick or treating.
Yeah. And it's just okay to have a little mellowness.
It is okay on occasion to have a little mellowness. It's like the Orlando thing. Sometimes it's okay to just cry and paint.
But tonight
is going to be crazy. I'm going to do a whole big glow makeup thing and everything.
Mm-hmm. You guys.
So I've got my dogs in purple here, and I'm using my number 2 because it's giving me some control. I'm going to just come along here and do his lips in the dark purple.
Jump over here. I thought I saw a really good question come up here.
I love really good questions.
So,
just doing a nice little lip to accentuate his beautiful toothy smile. What's our question?
Oh, so just there was a. You're just right now using regular paints. None of these are glow paints right now.
None of these are glow paints.
Okay, so this is just on. You're doing this
any
on a black.
Any questions on glow paints? Though I actually feel real qualified to answer because I've been messing with them for like a year.
Yep.
Since Christmas last year, really, because we have a whole playlist on glow.
Mm-hmm.
How you can convert your art studio to a glow studio for like pennies at the Home Depot.
And you know what? Flame has been graciously throwing the links up to that.
Oh, has she?
She has. It's right there in the chat there. So, and I'm sure we'll get that in the iCard and the links below for you time travelers.
Yes.
Who are joining us?
Yeah, I think actually the playlist is in the iCard.
Is it?
I think I did that.
Oh.
I feel like I did that, but.
You know, it's a good day when we get planning going.
You know, it was so hard to get Spider in his Vader costume. Such an event.
Yeah, we're going to have to post some pictures of the kids up. Everyone was asking, where is it? Where are the kids' pictures?
And John was went as Bone Daddy.
I had a, it's right. My mom got me a really neat costume. So it was a skeleton painted on a suit. So I wore it. That was cool.
Yeah. I wore this hat.
Cinnamon went as the Sherpa.
This lower lip is thicker than the upper lip. It's about twice the thickness of what you do your upper lip as. This lower lip. Twice the thickness.
Ooh.
And the reason we're breaking up the blacklight paint from this paint so much is so that people who haven't been able to come to a live show can actually come to one tonight.
Yeah. And, you know, we have people who are all over the world who wanted to join us. And we thought, hey, it would be a good night to just, you know.
Break it up.
Yeah. And we haven't had a late night painting. And
so I'm painting the purple all the way up through the teeth and then joining it up there. So, see, it's not that hard. This is a good time to take your black and clean up in the teeth, too, if you want. If you'd like, you could do it. If you want.
And you're using that little number 2 shader?
I've got my number 2 shader. You can use any detail brush that you have, though. This is just the brush that I find very comfortable that I trust. I tend to buy them in packs when I see them. Because they give me a lot of options and small detail work.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and never be beyond using a miniature brush. I think that that's in, I talk about these in my studio setup video, how much I like them.
Yeah.
I am doing deep breaths. Who else is finding themselves very anxious lately?
So Sandy is asking.
I have what? It, and I'm just like, gonna let it go, let it go. What's Sandy asking?
Oh, she's asking a question about what, does anyone know what ingredient makes glow paint glow under black light?
Well, there's two different kinds.
Mm-hmm. So do you want to talk about that? The differences of the phosphorescent and luminescence?
Well, I'm going to give my explanation, then John will probably give a better explanation. But fluoro paint gives the appearance visually, like this is fluorescent, of being like almost, you know, vibrant in daylight, and is a cheap, bright, intense paint that was developed for, what was it, the construction industry or the home industry?
Yeah.
It had an industrial starting place, and it's so luminescent in the daytime, but it's also blacklight reactive. Like if you put a blacklight on it,
so yeah,
I have a blacklight flashlight somewhere.
Yeah.
I'm gonna show it off. I have so many cool blacklight things for this evening. You're gonna freak out. Necklaces, blacklight flashlights, all kinds of things. And then the luminescent paints, they charge the particles in the paint. Charge and hold. And is it energy? During
photons.
Photons, and then so at night glow. And there are some really good products in both lines. Not everything that says neon will glow, but everything that says fluorescent will glow, and everything that says luminescent will glow.
So fluorescent means that it reacts under it fluoresces under lights. So it generally, you know, it's highly reflective and is not necessarily self-illuminating. You know,
yeah.
Glow paint. Which absorb is self-illuminating, and and the trick is that not all fluorescent paint is UV reactive, and not all glow paint is UV reactive, even though most are. So it's one of those experiment things.
I'm outlining his eyes with his black paint.
Yeah, so it's good to have a black light flashlight to find out what things are UV reactive.
None of this. Is fluoro-reactive, but you can see some of him is.
Be back out there.
See how the dog's inning isn't?
Oh, yeah.
But the blue is.
Yep.
I have a link on the black light painting on where one could get one of these clever, crafty little flashlights.
Yeah.
And glow necklaces that are awesome, and glow Kevins that are awesome. That's right. We have a glow Kevin tonight.
Oh, yes.
Ooh. So I'm just taking out this white line that I have on here with my black paint going around the eyes, like eyeliner. Going around the eyes like eyeliner.
Like eyeliner.
Eyeliner. I'm going to rinse out my brush. And I think I'm going to pull in a number 4 bright or a number 2 bright. Number 2 bright. So this one, and on the stiff filaments, it gets real stiff when it's real small, almost too stiff.
Mm-hmm.
But I still like it, so I use it. And I'm going to pull out some of my blue paint. I'm going to use some of my glazing liquid because my paint's drying on me, and I'm going to mist it.
Now you're
I have a very hot, dry studio.
Yeah, you're just using regular paint right now. None of this
regular
is
paint. None of this is glow paint.
None of this is glow.
On the listing for the glow painting tonight,
mm-hmm.
I have links to what I like. My favorite glow paints and one of my favorite glow companies that sells like the necklaces and the pens to sign the painting and the flashlights and all of that and really cool party accessories. So I'm just putting this in blue at first on both sides where I've painted in the iris, and I may be coming back to get rid of my chalk because my chalk is quite bright. But I may not be because it looks like it's just depends on if it comes out and I'm painting it out. And I'm going to add a little white to my paint to lighten it. And the lower half of the eye, you can see I'm doing in this lighter blue. This is the first. Was that from Who We Think?
No. We had a...
I was almost so excited.
Oh, yeah, it is.
It is?
Yeah. But, what happened was is that...
Waiting on a package that just showed up, y'all. Been real tense about it, but there it is, and I'm so excited.
I know, we'll talk about that later, but that was funny. So they really...
I will talk about it later. Later I'm super excited right now, and they're just here because this is live.
It happened. So they want pop art. More pop art.
Oh, I love doing pop art, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
I do. I love doing pop. We got to do like the Maryland... We got to do some Andy Warhol, don't we?
Yeah.
Some point.
Now, the interesting...
Some Maryland pop art, some... Audrey pop art, some fun stuff. So I'm just pulling this in. And we're just coming here. And it's just the top half of the eye right now is dark and the bottom half of the eye is light. Lots more work to do on the eye, but we want to lay this in so when we come to do the work later, we get a really tremendous result.
Yeah.
All right, so we've got all that in. Now I'm going to get my number four.
Your number four.
I change up my, my number four. Which you'll see, why do I change it up? Because of the convenience it creates for me. See the difference? This is going to cover more canvas. So I'm not working. One of the things that happens to new artists is you get really too tiny of a brush, and you're like, it took me 6 hours to do this painting. So in art school, one of the things that they do is they take all your little art brushes away and make you work a painting with just one brush.
Just one brush.
No, sometimes I'll do that. I'll forget I'm working with new people, and I'm like, I'm just going to paint this whole thing with a number 10. And I got to remember to take it down. So it's an interesting thing. The journey. I'm going to add some blue stripies. One of the things about the picture-in-picture is we didn't get it color-balanced, I think, well enough before we got it in. So you can't see the difference between the purple and the blue as much as I would like. So I'm taking a little of the blue and a little of the white, and I'm going to come in and add some of the blue and white stripes, which are till about here.
Oh, they're like, we want more Texas snow.
Texas snowflakes on
Texas
my face.
Texas snowflakes.
I love my Texas snowflakes. So you can see I'm just doing like a little fur motion with my brush.
You're spooking me. I keep thinking you're going for more paint, and you don't. You're just...
I'm just looking at the reference.
You're just looking at reference.
Yeah. See where I had the blue and purple? Now I'm going for more paint.
I see you sneaking around on me.
Put a little blue right here. He's going to be a lot more vibrant than the reference photo. He's going to be more like the thumbnail that you see. All right, we're going to come in here. Just give him some of this blue fur in here. And I'm going to come and give him a little bit above here.
Kim Sim just dinged Christy. She's an artist.
Dinged Christy?
Yep. Ding, you're an artist.
Oh, good. Christy, you're an artist. I agree with Kim Sim.
If anybody else needs an artist, if everyone needs to become an artist, feel free to get dinged.
I'm going to come above here.
And so for those of you who are not in the chat, not knowing, Cinnamon once said, ding, you're an artist. And so that's just sort of stuck. And so.
But it's so true.
You want to explain that a little more?
So here's the thing. A lot of times people will ask, when do I get to be an artist?
Yeah.
When? Along my art journey, do I get to be an artist? Ding! You're an artist. If you're painting, you're an artist. An artist, way more famous, way more influential, have said this, but way before me. It's not like a new idea. Van Gogh said, if you have a doubt that you can paint, then paint by all means and remove all doubt. Yeah. Just do it. It's just painting. That's just painting. Painting is
I like that particular phrase.
What makes you an artist? You can be an artist in a three-piece suit. You can be an artist and a power lifter. You can be a big guy, giant guy, right, at the gym, that can deadlift huge amounts of weight and also still be an artist. There is no... Do you remember the crocodile wrangler guy that was in my art class, John?
Oh, Buck.
Buck.
Man, how'd I pull that out?
I'm so glad you did. Buck really left an impression on me and made me redefine creativity and how, you know, what I thought of as artist and realize that I'm never going to be able to look at somebody and have any idea what's going on the inside. Because Buck was like 7 million feet tall and as wide as a house and didn't wear shirts. No. But he did not wear shirts. He wore a leather vest.
He wore the skins of other animals. Right. I'm not even, I mean, like, on his hat, on his boots, and his knife, everything. Yeah. And this is like, I guess, you still get this in Texas and in some of the really, you know, and there's a similar, I think, up in the north, you get some deep woodsmen.
Buck looked like he could make jerky by looking at it. Buck could cure meat by staring it down.
Buck was the guy
and
who...
I actually did a photography expose on him. He lived in a metal factory and had a pet alligator and a one-legged chicken and a three-legged dog. And yeah, that's exactly how you think it happened to the chicken and the dog.
You know, Buck wasn't uniquely guilty of this, but I had a lot of high school friends who would, cure roadkill. I don't know what that was about, but, you know, they're just a little too far off into the woods.
No, they're fantastic. And you know what? And there's honor
in
everything.
I'm with them because I'm out there, too. So, I mean, you know.
There's honor in everything. But the thing is like, you know, we get ideas of what people are in our head. And Buck was a very good sculptor and a very sensitive person. And he had a beautiful artistic vision.
And an amazing leather worker.
And an amazing leather worker.
Which you just wouldn't expect.
You know, I had another friend, Dan Backer, huge guy too.
Yeah, Dan, legitimately biker dude, huge. Yeah. You'd think plays with metal. He does. He has a giant
Makes
laser.
The happiest little chef sculptures.
You know, has a plasma cutter, you know. Cuts metal, does all, and then makes these the cutest.
I'm not explaining what I'm doing, John. We got to.
Okay, we're just off. So what are you doing there? You're loading your brush.
I'm doing the blue, and I'm putting it right here above the lip. I'm leaving a little space to come back in with the purple, but I just wanted some of this blue highlight right there.
Okay, so we'll get.
Sorry,
back.
I just. Oh, then I'm gonna get all those notes. Like you talked. This makes me so mad.
So what are we doing here to make the first? So
I've got my number four loaded. If you look at this, I've got my number four loaded.
Yep. Now you've got
it's
a lot
on
of
a bead on the brush.
I noticed you got a lot. There's paint all over that brush.
There's paint all over the brush. It's starting to creep up. What I could do actually with that, if you see, is I can take it into my towel, wipe it off.
Yeah.
And pull it out and reload. I can re-wet, drag off, come back over and reload into the blue with a little white.
Uh-huh.
And just get my bead going back again.
Okay.
I'm going to come underneath the lip here. Underneath the lip. It's because the teeth go over the lip. This is very important, the overlapping of these teeth.
Oh, yeah.
It's huge to this character. So I'm coming and I'm using the sharpness of my brush to tuck out these details.
Hold on a second. Am I my program going crazy here?
I don't know.
Oh, no, there it goes.
I've just loaded up some more blue, and I'm just pulling that out. And I'm just pulling the brush. I'm curving the brush stroke to imply the fur right here. And I'm going to bring some purple back between these two. I just got to make sure the yellow is really dry. One of the tricks whenever you're doing a piece that has yellow... blue and purple as a color scheme is that you've got to let the yellow dry before the purple engages it. Otherwise, you'll get really grayed out colors. And you'll lose the vibrancy of the painting.
Oh, that's what happened.
So I'm just loading. See, I just keep putting this bead on here.
Yeah.
And I'm just coming underneath. Just making sure I use the sharpness of my brush to create a clean line. And then squareness of my brush to create the fur. Curving that stroke. And letting it taper and pull out. I'm coming back, covering up these little beads. I hope I'm doing okay.
You're doing really good. This is really good. Everyone's really enjoying this, actually.
It's
right
weird
now.
And
they're,
off
they
day.
Like the pop art stuff. There's a lot of people saying they're really looking forward to some more of that.
Yeah. Well, and I just try to keep up the fun because I, you know, I want everyone to have access to the things that they like. That's why I like doing stuff based on your guys' you're so going to love the ruby slippers.
Oh, yeah.
Get your glitter. Get your glitter now. Because that's happening again.
There's gonna, it's
if
gonna
you're
be...
new to the channel, every once in a while, we do glitter painting.
Mm-hmm.
After we do a painting. And also fun. Mostly done during the holidays.
And we even occasionally, like, we'll do other glitter fun things.
Yeah.
Glitter experiments.
Is just, glitter is, John is glitter bearded.
We, that's right, I did. That's the intro.
So I'm just pulling this out and just making sure that this fur is here. So we have all this, and now I'm going to rinse my brush out.
They'd like to see some armor jousting.
Sure.
Yeah, there's been lots of comments on that.
See where I have the yellow here in my with my white?
Oh,
everything
I do,
I've got to make sure I keep my purple out of that. And I'll show you why. When purple and yellow mix together, they make this color. Not very bright. Now, it can be wonderful if you're intentionally trying to make it. Not a lot of fun if you don't mean to have it.
Goodness,
no. All out of my brush. I may even switch to another number 4. This is my Pro Stroke Power Krill. This lovely gentleman. I love this guy. All right, so I'm pulling out the little fibers. I'm pulling out the white. And by the way, I'm not mad at Goldilocks. I know I've been getting a lot of questions about that. Goldilocks is still loved. Still $3 at various retailers if you can get her. All right. So I've taken a little purple and white. I find with dogs eating purple, if I want it to read differently than black, I've got to brighten it with a little white.
Now, I had a question about...
pull this up at the nose.
I had a quick question here on just on general on the glow paint stuff here.
Yeah.
So can you add glow to any kind of paint to make it glow?
No. The pigments actually can really diminish the glow.
Interesting.
I mean, you can do it. It doesn't explode.
Just not as effective.
It just may not have the result that you're looking for. I'm coming in between our stripes with this purple. And hopefully you're really seeing this on this one. You can kind of see the brightness of this piece.
Mm-hmm.
You know, now that we, because this camera sees these so well. See, and I'm just feathering up. And I have to tell you, like, I started this feeling a little shaky today.
Yeah.
It happens. Don't worry about me. I know y'all worry. But this is what I'd be doing if I was feeling off. John, I'll tell you, I'd be painting. I'd be I feel a little off. I need to paint. That's how I find my way back to me.
So Mandy was talking about that here in chat and was curious. So she's...
just going to continue filling in the black spaces with my purple.
I think what she's saying here is she has about 50 unfinished paintings laying around. And she's looking to try to find out how to get back to them. You know, that sometimes you just get in the middle of one and just, you know, get bored or can't find the energy to finish it. So.
That's a hard problem that artists struggle with. And we talk about the creative energy. I've just added a little more white to this, and I'm just pulling in this fur. I'm pulling this here.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that was something in my youth I really struggled with, is getting into a project and then not being able to find my way out of it or back to it. Start something. I think things have a creative energy and time, and it can be really hard to do that. One of the things that broke that for me was daily painting.
Oh, yeah.
The daily painting process is I'm going to paint a painting every day no matter how I feel.
Mm-hmm.
And at some point during that, around painting 30 or 40, you stop even like going online and looking for pretty pictures you might want to paint, and you'll be like, oh, there's an egg on my plate. I could probably paint that. You just start painting what's there. And then you start seeing how everything is beautiful. It's a really weird moment. And you start going around telling everybody that you know how beautiful the world is. And have they seen it recently? And then your friends stop calling back because they're not really sure what's happened to you. And then it kind of comes full circle around painting, what, 150?
Yeah.
You stop telling everyone that they just got to know about how beautiful the world is. And how meaningful it is. And then you just kind of get back to, this is my process. And then you start to notice that if you paint, just paint, you just commit to that painting process,
mm-hmm.
that if you're in a bad place, you start taking what's happening in your life and you start putting it in the canvas. You take it out of your heart and you put it into your art.
Yeah.
It's incredibly powerful stuff.
Yeah,
and I'm really very grateful to artists like Carol Marine for making that a, you know, public known activity.
Mm-hmm.
And helping me like find that back in myself, because that absolutely, you know, even in advertising art, even though I worked all the time and worked when I didn't feel well, nothing more than daily painting has taken, I don't wait for creative inspiration to paint. I find creative inspiration while painting. Healing, yeah. Healing stuff for me. My experience.
Yeah, I think that's shared by a lot of people here.
So I love to see like when you guys are like, I'm on painting number 23. I'm gonna do a painting every day this week. I think it's Alan just did a painting like every day.
Oh yeah, you know, one of the things
I'm just coming through the blue and the yellow, and I'm blending in these little soft strokes, this purple between the blue and the yellow. I hope some people do some Cheshire Cats. I'm like really worried that I didn't do a good job today and that no one's going to paint.
Oh, I think you're going to get a lot of Cheshire Cats. There's a lot of people in here. Okay. Really interested in doing it. We got like over 160 people here, got over 165 likes. People have been really coming in and talking a lot about this. They've really enjoyed it in here.
I appreciate that, guys. I really do, because I know your time is valuable.
One of the things that I was just reflecting on that I really enjoyed as you were talking about daily paintings and as we're talking about pets is I really enjoy when I meet artists who made a daily practice of painting or drawing their pet, because it's like I met a guy who had a veiled chameleon as a pet and drew it all the time.
Yeah.
And so he could draw the most emotive chameleon I had ever seen.
Yeah, he's really painting himself.
And it's the same thing. I've noticed people who have bunnies or they have you know, like birds or mm-hmm. dogs or cats, and they paint them or draw them every day as reference material.
I'm bringing the purple around the eye. I so agree with you, John.
I was just impressed by that. And thinking
no, it is. It's really impressive. I'm just pulling this down here between these two spaces. I'm just really making sure that the black canvas is getting covered. If I start to lose my purple, I'm going to pull out a little white. So that lightens up a bit and will then pop.
Yeah.
Oh. You know how that does that? If my purple stops being there. But I want my purple dark right around this eye. And this inner eye color, you want it to be almost a pure purple.
So Christy has...
Hi, Christy. How you doing, sweetie?
A bunny, a bird, a dog, and a cat.
Or a bunny, a bird, a dog, and a cat.
And, well, there was a bunny, a bird, a dog, and cats. So
okay.
I'm not sure. There was no... The all of the other ones were in singular use, so.
So I'm just getting that purple in.
Ooh, a chinchilla, too.
Oh, I love chinchillas. They're so funny.
Dusty.
I'm going to wipe off my brush, and I'm going to go dark around the inside eye. Wipe off my brush and go dark around the inside eye.
And fish. Oh, a fish.
And by the way, if you guys want to keep the chat going, you know how YouTube always kind of bumps you out?
Oh, yeah.
And you don't want to have to wait till Angela's show comes on. Angela's on at 7? Angela's on this evening, and my mom's on this evening before we're on. I think we're going to end up being on at 9, even though this mm-hmm. is 8:45, because John's got to do scouts. Where was I going?
You were going to say that
chat continues on the website. We have a chat room for you guys on the website because we're always like, YouTube like kicks you out. They're like, you can't go home. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. Bye. So if you guys are, you know, in an important conversation or really connecting on an art level or anything like that, you know, you can go over to the website and join the chat there and just keep talking to each other like you're here. It's mm-hmm. pretty cool.
And
all right. I feel like he's in.
I think so. I think it's looking pretty good.
I feel like now I got to do his eyes. Got to do my eyes. Eye thing. I got my reference and reference now. I got to see my reference. References. There he is. All right. So I'm going to do a thing where I take a little of my blue and a little of my purple, and I'm going to mix them together. I'm going to pull out my glazing because it's getting very gloppy from the dryness of my studio. And I'm going to start creating the shadow. Underneath a lid is always a shadow.
Ah.
Well, not always, but mostly you know you've got a shadow coming. You have a shadow. And so you want to make sure that you pull that shadow into your eye. We kind of gave ourselves a guide that that was happening earlier. And I am making sure that my eyeball is holding a nice shape. Coming around here. I really like the glaze for doing eyes. If you lose your eyeliner, don't worry. You can easily come and put it back in. Easily. Then you're going to pull out your... I wipe my brush off of my towel. You're going to pull out your white and come... I mean, your blue and come over your white. And make a very light tipped brush. You can kind of see how it's not even. I haven't mixed it. And then around the inside, around the iris, you're going to start pulling this out. This light. You can even take it a little bit up into the shadow. I'm going to come and get a little blue. And again, a little white. Now I'm just pulling this out. Wipe my brush. I'm going to get a little of my pure blue. I'm just going to tap this in. I'm trying to shade this so that it feels round. So it needs to be a little darker at these outer edges with the blue. Just shading it in, feathering it in. Everything in him is going to be in the eyes, and when we take him to blacklight especially. Come in and get some more white, just white. I just wiped my brush off, but I didn't rinse. Just make sure you've got some of this highlight happening here and a little bit here in the lower half. See how that pops it?
Oh, yeah.
Let's go work the same thing on the other side. A little of the blue, a little of the white. You may need to glaze if it's glopping up on you, as it is on me. And just start feathering it out. Feather it out. You can totally do this. You got this. You know, you got this. I hope the live lessons are still fun.
Oh, yeah. There's a lot of people actually there chatting. I was just making some comments in here in the chat. They were asking about the website and how the chat stuff is working and where to find more information about it. So I was just answering some questions.
Cool.
Oh, yeah. No, there's a lot of people really enjoying it. And, you know, they wanted to say thank you to you, Sherpa, for doing all of this stuff. You know, there are a lot of people were saying that they just appreciated you putting all this up there. And there's a lot of congratulations on you hitting 64,000 subs. Or 84,000 subs.
Don't take away 20. I know there are those that want to, but don't do it.
No.
All right. Okay. So I'm just pulling this out. Yay. All right. So now is a good time to come back and make sure that the lining around your eye is good. So I'm back to a number 2 shader. And I'm just going to very delicately work around the eye. Just make sure that this is as defined as it needs to be. And then come back in and make sure that the iris is defined as it needs to be.
Mm-hmm.
And then another thing that you can add with the black once you have this is the sort of Cheshire Cat eyeliner that he has. See?
Mm.
Gives him that pop. Gives you that pop. Everybody gets a pop from eyeliner. The other place I can put is between the eyes and the corner of the nose.
Oh, yeah.
It's subtle. I don't know if the camera can pick it up, but it'll make a difference in your finished piece.
Yeah, just let me see if I can probably go in and I just up to touch. You can barely catch it in there.
Yeah. It's because the dog's in purple is such a deep color.
Oh,
it's
we can definitely see the
black. Black.
So, oh, yeah. You can see the black on there for sure. Yeah.
So I'm just coming up over the eye.
And it definitely, you know, it lines it out.
Believe it or not, we get to do this all again in blacklight paint. But the wonderful thing about this style of blacklight painting is that your painting looks amazing during the regular day.
Yeah.
And then also looks good under blacklight.
That's really what's cool.
Yeah, that's what I'm going for, yeah. Two stages of awesome. Just make sure we have here. And then we have one last thing. One last thing. And that is, I'm going to get my number two out, and I'm going to just load just the tip. You can see it's just the tip here.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to make a little reflection right here.
Now, they were noticing that you've got some more yellow highlights on the example here.
Where?
If you, over here on the, see how they there's more yellow highlights there on the,
like
where you were using, yeah, down there around his mouth and some things like that. There were some yellow differences. Like you used more oranges and more yellows in that. Now, is that because
this is just the color
the
balance
light?
Was on that was crazy.
Ah, okay.
Oh, on this one?
The one in the picture there.
I think I missed a little yellow right here.
Ah, okay.
That I could have put in.
So just you had some more yellows that you could add.
Yeah.
If you want to put some more in.
If you want to put some more in, we can put that in. We can go around and look. And it's just, this is a good time to do it because it's all dry. Don't do anything that has purple on it. You know, so we can come here and add that. And you can come back and refine anything that you feel that you lost real quick with your yellow. Refine anything that you feel. So your camera does not necessarily see a piece as it is. So sometimes, like, you'll do something that's like one color paint and it will interpret it as two
because
it sees the canvas underneath.
And once you add some black light, it'll also, the black light paint, it also changes it a little bit.
It changes it a lot. When we'll look at the two different paintings,
one with black light on it, one without.
Yeah. You can come up here and you can just, you know, make this more noticeable. Anything that you want to strengthen at this stage.
You can just pop that in there.
Yeah. You can just pop that in. You can take that any direction. See, now that everything's dry.
It's real easy just to.
Yeah.
Shoo, shoo, shoo.
Okay.
There you go.
Just keep layering. Acrylic paint is never hurt by layers.
Oh, thank you, Rhonda. And I hope that everybody else out there is feeling better today, too.
Oh, good, Rhonda.
So everyone, Rhonda was saying that she's feeling better and just happy to be here. So thank you, guys.
Oh, I'm with you, Rhonda. I'm feeling a little better and just happy to be here. There are days where it's like that, you know.
And I hope to see a lot of these guys posting up. Please post them up on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram, on TheArtSherpa.com. Want to see lots and lots of these.
And here's the thing. If you don't have a blacklight set up right now, let me tell you, you are a lamp and one bulb away.
And it's, I mean,
it's
like.
It's so easy.
And it's so cheap right now because it's the day after Halloween.
Yeah. We kind of timed this so that you would have the cheapest conversion rate that you could possibly have to go blacklight. So this is him blacklight.
Oh, yeah.
This is him before the black light. See that? Now, this glows like a crazy, it looks like it's lit up with like light bright. Mm-hmm. They're like light bright paintings. So check out, I have Instructables on it. I have all kinds of stuff where you can just go get the bulb. If you're a grown up and you haven't been delighted, laughed, or giggled in a while, I have to tell you, black light might be your jam. It really was mine. When I started doing black light painting, I was like, oh, it was like last year, and I was like, I think this might be a trend. And so we hooked up the studio, but beyond that, I found myself, my kids, and my friends just had a great time.
Yeah.
Just doing it. And it's so much fun. It's not expensive to convert over. It's a lot of fun. And afterwards, you can get these little portrait lights and put a black light bulb in them so that it's luminescent all the time.
Yeah.
And if you get a good paint company, if you do Golden, Matisse, Derivan, or Lucas, they're going to last the longest of all the blacklight paints.
Oh yeah, why is that? Just based on what you've discovered there?
All blacklight painting is not as permanent as regular pigments. None of these are considered permanent pigments. The ASTMDR doesn't consider them permanent pigments. However, some paint companies have really like loaded the pigments heavily, stabilized them as much as possible, and increased their longevity. So as long, I would say the lifespan of a blacklight painting is about the lifespan of a velvet painting. As long as you're into it, it will probably work. And just at the point where you're like, I gotta get that glowing painting off my wall, is probably when it's not going to maybe have as much phosphorescent as it did. And they're not expensive paints. Not even the pro levels of the blacklight paints are expensive. And the craft lines all have a line. Martha Stewart has a line. I've used her line. I've used the craft lines. My favorite is, of course, Derivan and Lucas for it. But, you know, I mean, there's $3 little plops of Artist Loft. I think those have the shortest lifespan. I've actually seen those fade out in 6 months.
Ah.
But the fun is forever.
Yes.
And it won't fade out, like, not be bright on your canvas. It just won't be as phosphorescent. So it will still look like this as regular paint. So, anyhow, see you tonight at 9.
Oh. And we're gonna give big hugs to Rhonda, who's feeling down a little bit. And I saw when I saw her coming in, she had just said that she was already feeling up a little bit, but she's just having a big art. So what a big art hugs to
big
her.
Big art hugs to me too. I'm with you today.
And she needs some support. So you know, and I just caught that. So sorry, Rhonda. I'm just, you know, we're always seeing, you know, I'm trying to catch the chat as it comes up in here, but want to give you big art hugs and know that. You know, any of you guys who need, you know, need support from other artists and other your community members, please, you know, please use the site. Please come be here. The Art Sherpas here, y'all here. So Sherpets are here. I'm all over the place.
I think y'all are. It's the candy.
It's the candy.
I want to see you guys tonight at 9.
Yes.
I hope you guys are great. And I will catch you on the flip side where we're all mad here. Okay.
Love you guys.
I'll catch you tonight at 9 p.m. Bye-bye.